Now let's come to the next topic, that is refraction through spherical surface. Refraction through spherical surface में दो part होंगे, एक होगा convex और एक होगा concave. Definitely उनके derivations का जो तरीका है वो थोड़ा थोड़ा अलग है, but जो final result है वो same है. तो हम concept को लेकर के चलेंगे और उसके according solve करेंगे यहाँ पे. तो if you are able to solve for the convex, then you can easily solve for the concave. And definitely you have read these things in your 12th class also. तो मैं एक का सिर्फ आपको derivation बताऊँगी and how to apply it that we will use in numerical. Okay? So let's say refraction at spherical surface. Refraction at spherical surface. मैं यहाँ पे आपको किसका बताने वाली हूँ? That is of convex. कि कॉन्वेक्स में हम कैसे करते हैं. तो चलिए आइए लेकर के चलते हैं कॉन्वेक्स का एक लेयर. कॉन्वेक्स सरफेस की ये एक लेयर हो गई और ये आपका कॉन्वेक्स सरफेस के अंदर का पार्ट है. दिस इज योर प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. ओके, दिस इज योर प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस एंड दिस इज योर पोल हियर. डेफिनेटली यू हैव टू राइट योर फोकस and then center of curvature. So this is my focus, center of curvature. And in this convex, I want to tell you that image is always real. Convex ka kya hai? When we get refraction through spherical surface that is convex, then image is always real. To kuch aise point hai jo aap dekh karke hamesha nikal sakte ho ki kya option mein kya aana chahiye. Ab jaise ki iske pehle main yahan pe एक नॉर्मल भी ड्रॉ कर देती हूँ. सो लेट मी टेक इट एनी पॉइंट. दिस इज थ्री नॉर्मल और नॉर्मल के इस पॉइंट को भी मैं यहाँ पे एन से रिप्रेजेंट कर रही हूँ. ओके, नाउ लेट सी हाउ रिफ्रैक्शन टेक प्लेस इन दिस केस. नाउ दिस इज योर द मटेरियल इनसाइड द ग्लास एंड दिस इज योर एयर. सो दिस इज योर ऑब्जेक्ट एंड नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द रूल ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन. सो लाइट इंसिडेंट फ्रॉम द ऑब्जेक्ट okay reaches to this point. Okay, now it has to go like this way, but because it is going to the denser medium, it will bend towards the normal, and if it will bend towards the normal, then you will get its image something over here. Okay, so this is the object, this is the image. So this image is due to the direct lines, that means this is the real object. Now let's see how to do the derivation. We will do it very fast as we have done this in our 12th class. So from the object, whatever angle is subtended, that is my alpha. From the image, it is beta, and from the center of curvature, it is gamma. And see, here, I have joined this line. After many days, I'm using this white board, so it's a little different. And I'm going to mention it here only that P tends to N. And if P tends to M, in that case, I will take this distance as U, this distance as V, okay, and this distance as R, which is equal to twice of focal length, okay, focal length of this spherical surface. Now, let's try to find out the geometry. I have always told you that in ray optics, we always need a geometry to understand what's going on. So here you can see, this is your alpha, beta and gamma. And you have to find relation between U, V and R or F. And also refractive index of medium 1. And refractive index of medium 2. So this is my medium 1, which is having refractive index N1, and this is refractive index of medium 2, so N2. So I'm not going to write here air to glass means NG. I will write here N1 to N2. So according to the situation, you can change where it is needed. So let's see here. So what's the geometry is saying here? Geometry is saying that we have to find relation between this U, V, means some trigonometric function, some function in which we cover the base. Okay, and in this all the thing which is common, that is your this one, this NM is common. So something is coming common and we have to find this one. So the best approach is that we can take tan. So that is the reason that we are taking here tan alpha. So tan alpha is equal to NM upon u. I'm here not taking sign convention, keep remember. And tan alpha, then here tan beta is equal to nm upon v, and tan gamma is equal to nm upon r. Okay, now what can I do further? You know, if the angle is very small, because this is a small part we are cusping, so in that case, if alpha is very small, or directly I can write here, if angle is very small, then tan alpha means alpha nm upon u. This is u, and beta is tan beta is beta nm upon v, and gamma is equal to nm upon r. So this was about the geometry. Now let's see, what is this process? This process is your refraction. So if this refraction is your process, then definitely we have to acquire, we have to use the property of refraction. What is the property of refraction? So according to Snell's law of refraction, here you will get sin I. But what is I here? So let's see here that also, that what is here sin. Sorry, I. So this is the incident ray and this is the normal. So this is I, and here this is the normal line, this one, and this is my refracted ray. So this is the R. Okay, so this is my normal, this one. So this is my I and this is my R. So this one is medium one, this one is medium two. So what can I write over here? I can write very easily that sin I upon sin r is equal to n2 upon n1. As I told you, u law, yaha se yaha, I upon r is equal to iska refractive index upon iska. Theek hai, yaha se yaha gaya, yaha se yaha aaya. Theek, so something u time. Now, we have all the relation in terms of alpha, beta and gamma. But before the refraction, we have the relation I and r. So, we have to find some relation between I and alpha, beta, gamma. So again, you have to find some of the mathematics concept, as mathematics is our only tool in ray optics. So you can see here, these are your equation 1, this one is your equation 2. Now from exterior angle property, it is clear that this is my normal. So I is equal to alpha plus gamma. So from exterior angle property, we can write that I is equal to alpha plus gamma, and R is equal to, this R is equal to gamma minus beta by using the same formula, same concept, exterior angle property. Now till now we have used here this I and R, this law of refraction and this geometry, but how we will relate this? Now see, if angle is very small, because we can see whatever relation we have got, that is in terms of I, and here this is sin I. So how we will relate this? We can take this as if the angle is very small. So if angle is very small, then directly we can write that I upon R, so I upon R is equal to N2 upon N1, or N1 into I is equal to N2 upon N2 into R. What is your I? I is alpha plus gamma, and what is your R? R is your gamma minus beta. Minus beta. Okay, so we can take these N1 upon N2, N1 upon N2 into alpha plus gamma is equal to gamma minus beta. So let us take both gamma on the same side. So one is coming here. N1 upon N2 gamma minus of gamma is equal to here minus N1 N2 of alpha minus of beta. Okay, so aap yahan pe dekh sakte ho, this is N1 upon N2 alpha, I have shifted that side. N1 upon N2 gamma. Or a minus gamma, then minus n1 upon n2 alpha, that I have shifted and this one is minus beta. So let's now take here gamma is common. So this will come n1 upon n2 minus 1 into gamma is equal to minus, it will, this will come the same. So let's put the value of alpha, beta and gamma. So what we will get here, n1 upon n2 alpha minus beta. Next step mein dekhi. This is your gamma. So in the place of gamma, what we have to write, nm upon r. So n1 upon n2 minus 1. This is nm upon r is equal to minus n1 upon n2. For alpha, it is nm upon u. So this is nm upon u minus for beta it is nm upon v. So ye aapka kya ho gaya, nm upon v. Now you can see on the side there is nm, so you can cancel this nm, ye idhar se cancel hoga, and what you will get over here, you will get n1 minus n2 upon n2 to 1 upon r is equal to minus n1 minus n2 upon, no, here we can't take, sorry. n1 upon n2 into 1 upon u minus 1 upon v. Okay, so here I have not used here sign convention. After using sign convention, this u will become negative, and when u will become negative here, then the whole term will become positive. तो हम यहाँ पे इसको हटा के डायरेक्ट हम इसको यहाँ पे क्या कर देते हैं, पॉजिटिव कर देते हैं. सो व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग हियर, सो नाउ हियर यू कैन राइट हियर वेरी इजीली, दिस इज एन वन. टू फर्दर इफ यू विल कैलकुलेट दैट फर्दर यू विल गेट दिस एन टू अपॉन वी माइनस एन वन अपॉन यू इज इक्वल टू एन टू माइनस एन वन अपॉन आर. Okay, so this is the final result which you are going to get, in which case when the light is entering from one medium to another medium. Keep remember, when light is going from 1 to 2, in the medium 2 you are getting image. Aise aap yaad kar sakte ho. In the medium 2 you are getting image, in the medium 1 you have kept an object, and then n2 minus n1 upon r. लेकिन अगर यही होगा कि लाइट कहाँ से एंटर करेगी, लाइट अगर ग्लास से बाहर की तरफ एंटर करती है, सो उस केस में क्या होगा, आप n2 की जगह यहाँ पे क्या लिखोगे, 1 अपॉन n2. ओके, तो हम जब न्यूमेरिकल करेंगे तो इस बात को ध्यान रखेंगे यहाँ पे कि इस तरीके के क्वेश्चंस को हम कैसे सॉल्व करते हैं.